make my music for myself, but I also take into consideration that there's a lot of kids, especially from where I'm from, that don't really see beyond the lines that have been set for them and don't really aim higher than the ceiling that's been set for them. Like, I always try and mention where I come from and how stupid it is to dream big where I'm from, but I did, and look at what it's done for me.
The thing about Jnr is, he's not just a great African rapper, he's a great rapper who happens to be from Africa.
I give you Durban. This is where I grew up, this is my city, this is my home. It's a city that made me. It's kinda always summer here in Durban. The beaches here is beautiful, the women out here are beautiful. And this is a city that provides SA with most of the culture. So like the golden stuff, the dances and that type of stuff. And also yours truly.
Jnr is a star. A lot of kids love Jnr.
NSDC just changed the game.
What he has done hasn't been done by anyone here.
Someone that comes from a small town of Ilovo and make it out of the country and out of Africa, that's pretty dope.
Durban is an amazing place, man. And my part is to just take it out there, rep it to the fullest. I already travel all across the world, so I just have to carry it on my back.
I think he knocks down a lot of misperceptions that people have about African music and African art and African artists.
This is my home, you know? I get emotional every time I come here because it reminds me a lot of my upbringing. Skip school, not get in trouble, just be a good kid, you know? So this neighborhood is called Ilovo, in this section in particular.
Ilovo is not the most prominent town.
I'm not far from here. Like, a walk to my place is probably like 10 minutes or so. It's very close.
Jnr was he was an interesting kid. Extremely talented, but extremely creative.
Since I knew him, it's been like with music. Even our friendship was all about music at first.
They were huge fans of Lil Wayne. We had that in common. That's all we spoke about. We just spoke about fucking music. I grew up listening to house music, not by choice. It was just all that was playing around me. And Kwaito, Durban. Favorite house music and Gom more than hip-hop.
I don't listen to every hip-hop song, like rap and shit. That shit bores me. I want to turn up.
Growing up, there was a lot of R&B being played at the house. A lot of Gerald Levett, Brandy, Mariah Carey.
I remember they used to play Mariah Carey's Touch My Body a lot. That song used to play all the time. Like, hip-hop didn't play that often. But the first time I really paid attention to it was this one day. I was in grade four. There was a taxi that used to pick me up from home and drop me off at school, and then vice versa every single day, right? They had a drop screen in there, nice fitted speakers, the sound was perfect, and T.I. came on the screen. And that's what really caught my attention. And that's when I really started paying attention to different types of genres. And then I focused on hip hop, and then I just zoned in and started making beats and all that type of stuff. So this is also one of the rooms we recorded at. So my brother used to produce, he used to make house music beats. He taught me how to use the software to make all the sounds that I wanted. And I started off just like remaking people's beats, like a remake to Lil Wayne's Lollipop or whatever. I should just rap the exact same thing. And then eventually I started changing the words and putting in my own words. We really used anything we could find. We just worked with whatever we had. So at first, because I didn't have a microphone, I used to use Nokia headphones. And the cable was so short, and we weren't using laptops at the time, it was PCs. So I literally have to duck my head just so I can stick it into the tower and be able to record and then come up every time I hit record and go down and shit. This shit was nuts, bro. Probably only started taking it seriously when I was like 13 years old, because then I was really making my own music, speaking about my own true experiences and stuff. People really started like listening to me and what I had to say.
He came out of his shell. That's when I really saw that, okay, this thing is really gonna take off.
So my first official mixtape that I put out was called One Kid, A Thousand Coffins. Because it was my first really like official project, it took me months to make. I'd never taken so long to make anything. People really respected it and the hard work that I put behind it.
You were like hustling, bruh.
Like literally every single day the kid was before me.
Doesn't matter what distractions are around, he focuses on the prize.
Passionate. You were walking.
When he says walking, he doesn't mean just like a 15-minute walk or nothing like that. I used to walk, if not coming here, I used to walk all the way to Ifagaz. Yeah. I had to cross two rivers just to get there, just to record one song, maybe not even a full song.
He was always busy going around, like every day, even when the sun is hot as hell. Like the nigga will still come here and then do like a beat and record.
So this is the stream or river that goes up all the way through what really separates Ilovo from Ifagaz. There's no bridge that side or whatever. Like I had to cross two of these rivers. I'd have to walk first all the way from my house to like the river, which is quite a fucking walk. It's like nothing but fucking bushes and shit and insects. And then we'd have to fucking cross the river. The water would be anywhere from like from here up to like here. You know, to hold our clothes like this, our flash drives, our phones, across the river like this. And it's a moving stream also, so it's not just like still, it's actually like a current. So that shit was fucking scary. Now that I think about it, it was really dumb. I could have died, but I'm serious, bro. But it felt like there was no other way. It felt like if I wanted this thing to work, I had to do it.
At one point, his dad was like, you can't do music anymore.
Growing up, really, my father wasn't a fan of this whole music thing. He didn't like it. He didn't like it at all. He just thought it was a distraction from school, from church, from all the things that he taught me, because it's like, it's a culture where people sag and they smoke and they swear and stuff. And he rejected it completely. So at first, me and him didn't really have a cool relationship. And my mother passed away when I was like 11 months. I don't really know my mother. I felt like I didn't have anyone supporting me. I didn't have anyone supporting me like financially when it comes to this anyways. I never had anyone buy me a microphone or anything. I had to hustle for that by myself.
He took off really at 16. Probably didn't think that it would happen this quickly.
It's a bit of a challenge because when we have to take Junior to schools, that's not easy because these kids just go wild.
People knew my name and not just around my neighborhood, but kids from school, and they would take that and spread it in their neighborhoods. And I started to get a little bit cocky. I started to gain a little confidence. So I started feeling like, yo, I'm like the best rapper in Durban.
Ntsikayesizwe is the religion out here. My favorite brand is Nike, but now that Ntsikayesizwe is always wearing Puma. Now I got them turkeys now, like I'm wearing Puma too.
Every single time I'm in Durban, I stop by here. I make sure I stop by here. Even if it's not for long, even if it's like 10 minutes, just to dap them up, say what's up, and then leave. These are my homies right here. He's supposed to be the chef right now, but he's got
chef
no.
Capoteri,
nah, he's got.
I'm not sure that he really realized how big he was going to make it.
My first award ever, South African Hip Hop Awards, I think it was Best Newcomer. That happened in Johannesburg. I was really new there. When I went there, I wasn't really expecting to win. I was just happy to be nominated. But I actually got the award, and that was really cool. I remember the picture I took of one of my boys, PH. I was like smiling like an idiot. I hate that picture now, because you can see my gums and shit. I was smiling like, but it was a really beautiful moment.
Over the last 2 years, he's toured over 34 new markets that he's never experienced before. And each time he goes to a new country and learns about that culture, I see him grow and grow and grow.
Yo, boy.
Back in love.
You good?
What's going on, G?
Proper.
Nice.
Yeah, man, this is the venue.
This is home, man.
Yeah. You talk about how crazy it was the night that he sold it out?
Oh, yeah, which one?
Yeah, that was like 2018.
I won't lie to you. I was nervous. I didn't think we were gonna fill it out. So I have a tour called the Ivy Sun Tour. I do a run like every year. And my mother's name is Ivy, and I'm Ivy's son. So it's Ivy's son. It's really simple. I do everything for my mother. I do it in her honor. I've only ever heard stories of her, and I've seen a couple pictures, like 5 pictures max. But like, I feel like she's always watching over me and guiding me. She's like my guardian angel. She always makes sure I'm good, I'm nice.
When he lands on that stage, he just transitions into this monster, man, full of energy, passion. You can really tell that he loves what he does.
The first time we filled this venue up, that was the first time ever I got to bring my father on stage with me. It's the first time I got to take him to any of my shows. And when I was performing, I didn't know that he even knew my music that well to even be singing along to it. But I saw videos afterwards where he was dancing and singing along in the back. So
that's when really our relationship started blooming or coming alive or whatever. I really started understanding him and how hard he had it also. Like, he didn't have it easy. So when I really started looking at it that way, I started appreciating him more.
Looking at your journey and where you are right now, it's God's grace, you know?
Oh, yeah.
You are blessed. So I gave Junior this one advice. I told him, boy, destiny will find you no matter where you come from, regardless of your background. So now that you have that thing in you, don't forget the background where you come from.
My new album is called The Zulu Man With Some Power. I'm Zulu. Zulu is a tribe, right? So there's a whole bunch of different tribes in South Africa. There's Sotho's, Xhosa's, Bedi's, Zulu's, there's a bunch. I'm actually half Zulu, half Xhosa. My mother was Xhosa, but I grew up here in Durban with my father, so I'm Zulu. I'm a different flavor of Zulu, and that's what I'm trying to show to the world, you know? And letting people know you can be Zulu in your own way. You're born to be different anyway, so be different, but take pride in your shit.
He has inspired us a lot. I praise God, but I praise him more, like, because I've seen him. I've never seen God. He means so much. He inspired a lot of people, including myself.
I think he's uplifting the Durban community. They can look at him and see this is a kid that comes from where I come from and who can make it and can dream.
Young people, especially back at home, we've started seeing a lot of creatives popping up. I think it's just exposure. They now have someone that they can relate to and that comes from the same environment as them.
Now, like, everybody who wanna do music doesn't even get so, like, I'm shy. They just like, yo, I'm doing music too.
And what I hope to accomplish is to do exactly what I've been doing on like a bigger level. To get kids to know that being unique and being different is cool and it's something that they can use to their advantage as opposed to feeling like they're just stuck that way and whatever, you know? You know, I want them to feel like even if they come from the darkest places, they have an experience that someone else doesn't have. They could come out of that dark place and express that to the world and show the world what they have. That would be so much better. Durban is mine, Durban is home. Now it's time to take Durban everywhere else.
I see you change the way you feel about me when the lights hit my jewelry. It's a lot of bad things, yeah, I'm right where I should be. Every blessing that I prayed for fell right down onto me. Stress-free, I'm moving. Stress-free, I'm moving.